Hello, everyone, and welcome to Coastal Living. With me today is a very special guest. Please welcome Dr. Clorinda Phillips. She is Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs at Texas A&M University, Corpus Christi. That's a heavy title. Thanks for joining me.
It's really my pleasure. Thank you for the invite.
Absolutely. Well, I am TAMUCC alumni, proud to be, and it's an honor to join you today. It's definitely been something on my mind is what the seniors in high school and people in college are going through since we're kind of in this awkward place at the end of the school year. So what precautions are we taking at the university to accommodate the situation?
So although the university remains open, and albeit virtually for the most part, we are open and we're following all the CDC guidelines for social distancing. And we are, most of the faculty and staff are working remotely, and so they are not on campus. We have thinned out the campus quite a bit. We do have several hundred students that are still living on campus in our campus housing, and that's for a variety of reasons, including, you know, this has become their home and they may not have alternative housing arrangements. Some students want to stay close so they have access to the resources such as the computer lab. And for others, it's just this place where they find that they can continue to engage in their schoolwork best.
Absolutely. And for many of us, it is about the environment you're in and figuring out where it is that you are able to be the most productive, which I've finally created a space for myself to do that, but this wasn't that space before. So we're all adapting.
We are.
So you are able to accommodate the students that need to remain on campus that don't have any other living services available, correct?
Yes, and we were delighted to do that. We do understand that a hundred of our students don't have alternative housing arrangements, so they were allowed to stay on campus. We do have dining services available to them. It is carry out, grab and go. We also have other services available to them. The computer lab, for example, is open, and you have to call and make an appointment, and there is someone staffing the computer lab to make sure that we are following social distancing protocols, but also so that that person can disinfect computers after they are used by students. We have other services still available. We have our counseling and health center staff still available. They're taking appointments by phone. We have academic advising, and our academic advising staff are doing virtual appointments. Tutoring is also still available for our students. And so our goal really is that students continue to be successful in their coursework. And not only are they successful, but that we are able to help them reach their dreams and get to graduation.
Absolutely. And that's the ultimate end game, is we do have people that are expected to graduate this semester. So what can they expect as far as making plans? Are they going to be able to walk a stage? Will it be a virtual stage? What's that going to look like?
So commencement is the most important event at TAMUCC. And every time I think about commencement, every time we have commencement, I get emotional because it is so important to our students and their families, but it's also important to the university because everybody is investing their whole being into helping students achieve their dreams. So our students will be able to walk the stage. They will be able to invite their family and friends to celebrate that moment with them. We are fortunate that we already have an August commencement on the books, right? We already have an August commencement scheduled. And so those students who were planning to walk in May will be invited to walk in August. And if August isn't convenient for them, we will allow those students to walk in December or the following May 2021. So by all means, we plan to celebrate our students. We look forward to it. And I am excited about that event.
What about high school students that are finishing, whether they get to walk the stage or not? They're looking at colleges. And I know I was so eager to apply to the university. What's the situation look like for them?
High school students know better than many of us that we live in a digital world. Yeah. Many universities have, like many museums, have now are offering virtual tours. The Island University is offering virtual tours. The Island University is offering virtual tours. So we encourage students to come visit us on the island. What better place to do a virtual tour than on an island? So we're encouraging students to come to the virtual tour. They'll be guided around campus to see what it would be like to attend this beautiful campus. It's also the case that we have open chat sessions. And so after the tour, after the virtual tour, they'll be able to engage with an admissions counselor, a financial aid counselor, or any other staff that may be able to answer their questions. We have students that are here ready to answer current college students here, ready to answer whatever questions our high school graduating seniors may have. So we are still, as I said, open. We're full service. I encourage anybody that's interested in learning more about us to go to tamucc.edu/virtualisland. We will be delighted to see them. I will say to high school students, don't stop planning for your future. We understand that right now, and I have a niece that's a senior in high school, and she is grieving not being able to have her senior prom and not being able to have her high school graduation. And so we want students to grieve that, because that is something they were looking forward to. But also, I want them to look forward to what comes next. Keep planning, keep reaching out, getting the support you need, not only to finish this semester, but start the fall semester at the college of your choice, which we hope is TAMUCC.
Absolutely. You don't need the tour. You can just take my word for it. You want to be an Islander, okay? Yeah. And before we go, Dr. Phillips, thank you so much for your time. What advice do you have for the students before we finish this interview?
I would, on the Island University, I stress that although we are an island, that no one is alone. And so one of the things I would tell our students is that you are not alone. If you need anything, please reach out. If you don't know where else to contact, use Island Help at tamucc.edu. We are here and we want to be connected to you, and we want to support you, and we want to help you succeed. I would also say to our students that there are many of the services that we have moved online. And so there are people doing virtual bingo, and they're doing career services online. This is a great time to work on your resume or your cover letter. So make sure you're reaching out to the services that you need to be successful. This is a huge disruption. This is not what any of us planned. This is not what any of us thought our sort of spring 2020 semester would look like. But I want to tell our students that you can do it. You can finish this semester. You can be successful. Your faculty are great resources. So just tap into us like you would normally. You would normally use us and be in contact with us. Stay engaged. Let us know what you need.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Phillips, for your time. And if there's any other way Coastal Living can help you all get the word out, we're happy to do so.
Thank you, Clarissa, and you stay safe.
Amen. You too. Thank you.
Bye-bye.